God, yeah, it's a university. Now we tackle the big ones, the universities. So again, universities is basically just a blanket word. There are different kinds of universities that you can find also around the country in South Africa. So basically, you have like your traditional universities that you find in almost every province in the country, and then you also find like your online universities, you know, like the University of South Africa, which most, like literally almost 90% of their work, you do it online. So, which again, if you are a class of 2020, you kind of have more experience basically with online learning, of how it works, and also the discipline it requires, especially now that you're on your own, you're learning on your own, there's no teacher or someone to tell you more about how to do things. But I will actually do a video in the future basically of the basics basically of university life, of how it works, if you're interested in that. So yeah, if you're really interested in that, please give this video a like and subscribe, just to get more people to gain more information around this, and especially that I also work at a university, so this kind of helps. So if you also have any other questions, please ask questions and I'll be glad to answer those questions for you. Another thing with the universities that, like, universities usually have much more services and offer more in terms of support that sometimes you might not get in some colleges. But even though, but another disadvantage is that, for example, a university, you can be in a class with 400 other people, whereas and at FET College, you can be in a class with like 20 people. So, so there's also services that you can find in most universities, you know, like your writing centers. You can find your computer classes basically on how to do, like, to do the basics of computer work, or you have access to libraries, and especially with a service like the interlibraries. Basically, interlibraries is where you can be able to, for example, you're doing a research and then your university does not have that specific book. The university can actually order this book for you from another university, then you can find it at your own libraries. So, and also, you know, there's kind of like also some bursaries and companies who's, you know, are working with certain universities, you know, to also kind of help you, to provide you with more support, not just, you know, financially for your academic studies, but for much more, like, you know, comprehensive support, you know, for you as a person. They support your family, etc. So those are kind of support services that you can also find at the university. And also another advantage that universities have is that they usually have residences, where basically means you get to stay at a school. So if you're in high school and you're in a hostel, it is a bit of an upgrade to a hostel, but yeah, it's not that much. But then also with FET colleges, even also actually coming back to universities, most universities actually can only provide maybe up to 20-30% of their student population with the residences. So that's why now there's been a rise of private residence student accommodations around the country. Some of them are very affordable, some of them are ridiculously expensive that even the working community cannot afford such prices. So if you own those private residences, come on, these are students, stop exploiting students. Give students affordable accommodation, especially closer to the institutions, because people don't understand the power of being closer to where you're studying, because sometimes you need to do research into the, you know, very late hours. And then imagine now if you finish at school at about 11 p.m. and then you need to try and find transport to get home, and you live like 20-30 kilometers away from school, you know, like the impact that will have to a student. So please, if you have a house or you make sure to own like a building for students, student accommodation, please be considerate to students, okay?